Hello YouTubers, it's Champion DJK coming at you again with another video, and this is another episode of 10 Car Tuesday. I think this is going to be episode, 8 or 9, and this is Lamborghini. So we're going to take a look at some Lamborghini Hot Wheels, starting with this one right here. This is your number one. Your number one and number two are actually the same casting. This is the new for 2014 Lamborghini Veneno, and then this is one from 2015. All right, so the Veneno's been out 2014 mainline debut, 2015 mainline. 2015 it was also seen in the Zamac. 2016 it was in the Gran Turismo series, the premium one. 2017 mainline, 2017 Kroger exclusive. And then we also saw it, are seeing it this year, 2018, as a multi-pack exclusive in blue. So here's one of the debut ones. I think it probably came out in two colors that year. But here is one of them in a nice metal flake silver. Love the little green, red, and white there. Some Italian flag colors. So that is pretty sweet. Really cool looking casting. Hot Wheels did a pretty good job on this one. So definitely dig it. Let's see here, just trying to get the car centered in the frame. All right, so there's that one, and then let's open up this one from 2015 in red. I'm not sure, but I think it did come out with two colors in that year as well. Here it is in like a nice metal flake red, looking pretty sweet. I would like to do a custom of this casting at some point. I think it would be pretty cool with some Real Riders on it. We only seen it with Real Riders once. It was in the that Gran Turismo series, and I believe that one was yellow. Wasn't super an attractive version of it, and the wheels they picked I didn't really like so much. But anyway, these are metal body, plastic base, plastic tires. Cool cars, and that is your number one and your number two. Number three, we've got the Aventador. I'll take a look at the car real quick. This is the Lamborghini Aventador. This is a new model for 2012. This is the 2012 mainline debut. It was also in the 2012 as a Kroger exclusive, 2013 mainline, 2014 Exotics 5-pack. This one was also in a Gran Turismo series, 2016, but the one that was more like a mainline series, not the retro or replica entertainment one. And then it was also in 2016 Exotics 5-pack. And let's see, it also 2017 Lamborghini series. And it is a 2018 Super Treasure Hunt that is yet to show up here in the U.S., but will be out later this year, 2018. Here, and that's definitely going to be one I'm going to want for sure. This is a sweet one, though. Orange. We got a little bit of package rub on the top. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get that off of there or not. Probably not. But here it is in a metal flake orange. We got the headlight tampo, Lamborghini logo. Nothing on the rear. A little bit on the side. Plastic base, metal body. Pretty cool looking Lamborghini casting. I dig it. So there is that. And then staying with the Aventador, we have the Lamborghini Aventador J. This one, I am not a big fan of this casting. I'm going to say that right off the bat. It's all right. It's a Lambo. Pretty cool. 2014 is when this particular yellow one came out. This was a 2013 mainline debut. Was also seen, of course, in the 2014. Well, that's really messed up on the front there. 2014 mainline, 2015 Exotics 5-pack, 2017 Exotics 5-pack. I did not notice that at all in the packaging. But that is really messed up on the front there. Not sure what that's about. We got headlight tampos, Lamborghini logo, little side tampo there. Of course, metal body, plastic base. This thing just looks goofy, though. Does it not? I mean, I don't know. Looks like the top half of the car was just sliced off. Exposing a gaping, bloody wound. I mean, just doesn't look very cool. I don't think it does, anyway. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. This is probably the worst-looking convertible ever. Maybe not ever, but I mean, I just don't like it. So there is that Lambo. So I guess it's kind of cool that this one is, I mean, not cool that this one's screwed up, but out of all of them, this is the one I don't mind the most. All right, so there is that. Next up is the Revington Roadster. This one is kind of actually good-looking convertible. This is a 2010 new model, debuted in 2010. It was a 2011 Speed Machine, 2013 Speed Machines, and then in the 2017 Lamborghini Series. So here this one is. This is a very nice kind of like matte silver finish. Wheels look okay. This is a nice-looking car, I think. We got headlight tamples, of course, which is classic with Lamborghini. You get headlight tamples, you get the Lamborghini logo, and then usually really not much else. This one has got, this one actually does have taillight tamples on the plastic piece, as well as the Lamborghini right there. So that is kind of neat. The taillights are actually part of the plastic glass bit. So is this. So this is all one piece. And so they're kind of clear. So you probably can, you could put taillights in there pretty easy and light them up. But pretty cool casting. I like it. I like that one. I think that's a pretty neat Lambo. All right, so there is that. And then next up, number six, we got the Gardo LP570-4 Super Leggera. This is a 2011 new model. And here it is in 2011 in green. This one was seen in 2012 mainline as well, 2012 Lightspeeder series, 2013 mainline, 2014, there's a color shifter version of this, 2014, 2015, it also was a color shifter, 2016 Gran Turismo series, excuse me, the more mainline Gran Turismo series, not the Retro Entertainment, and, or wait, no, this one was in the Replica Entertainment, sorry, it did have a metal body, metal base, or wait, no, I am confusing it. Gran Turismo series, this thing was plastic. Plastic base, metal body, plastic tires. And then in also that same year this casting was released in the Forza series with a metal body, metal base, and rubber tires. And is an excellent release of this car. This is a pretty cool one. I definitely like this one. Again, we got headlight tamples, Lamborghini logo, tampo on the side, nothing on the rear. Yeah, so that little spot right there in the back, that's actually part of the plastic base of the casting. This one has a plastic spoiler as well, which actually I believe is a separate piece. Pretty cool little car. Dig it in green. I think it looks great. All right, so there's that. And then what are we on now? This is the Murcielago. This is a 2009 version of this casting. This one's actually an older casting. It debuted in 2003 on the mainline. It was also seen in the 2004 mainline. And then it had a couple of premium releases. 2004 West Coast Customs. I think it's been seen with rubber tires a couple of times maybe. There was that. 2009 mainline. 2011 Exotic 5-Pack. And then in the 2017 Lamborghini series. As far as Lambo castings go, this is another one I'm not like a huge fan of. I think it looks okay. I just don't think they really got the lines of this car down really. I mean, it looks all right. It's got taillight tamples, which is really cool. And it's got the headlight tamples, Lamborghini logo. Actually has a little side marker here too. Almost a three pass, I think here. Yeah, it's because it's got tamples right here too. So that's pretty nice. I mean, it looks all right. Just not my favorite. But Lamborghini nonetheless, and a pretty cool little casting. So there is that. And then next up, we got number eight. This is the Tuned Countach. Not a huge fan of tuned cars. Not a big fan of this one either. This one's from 2004. This is the first edition of this vehicle. They did a bunch of tuned cars in 2004. Just a goofy idea. It was seen here, and then it probably wasn't seen. I don't think it was seen again until 2013 in a multi-pack, 2014 multi-pack, 2017 mainline, and they've released, actually, I think, three different colors of it. in the main line this year, 2018. I think one being a Toys R Us exclusive. But I'd much prefer them release the old Countach casting. Well, actually, they've got a new one that's coming out in 2018 that I'm actually pretty excited about. So that's pretty awesome. I don't really care if this thing ever gets released again. I'm not a huge fan of the tuned cars. I mean, I don't know. Who really is? I mean, do kids even really like these tuned cars? Do they think they're cool? I have no idea. No idea. But it's got front headlights, Lamborghini logo, little side tampo there. It's orange. Plastic spoiler. That's a separate piece. Yeah. So, whatever. It is what it is. There it is. All right. So, sticking with it. The last ones are kind of lame. And I apologize about that. But you got to show them. It's part of Lamborghini castings here. This is a Lamborghini Stoke. Goofy car. This is the 2014 version of it. This debuted in the 2011 mainline. It was a mystery model in 2012. It was in the 2012 mainline, 2014 mainline. And it was also in the Lamborghini series last year, 2017. Not a big fan of this. Lamborghini sedan. It's a four-door Lamborghini. And if you're going to buy a Lambo, would you really buy a four-door Lambo if you had the money to buy a Lamborghini? This is kind of like buying the Lamborghini smartphone, if you've ever seen one of those. You just wouldn't. Why are they making it? Like, what? Why are they even brand? Like, I don't know. Whatever. That's my opinion. I'm sticking to it. And you get Lamborghini logo, of course, classic. Headlights. Little baby side tampo there. Nothing on the back. Plastic body, or plastic base, metal body. Nice silver color. And there is that thing. I don't even know if they ever actually made the Stoke. I don't. I think it was a concept car. I'm not sure if it ever got made. And then, speaking of that, this was a concept car at the time of release. This Lamborghini Urus. This was released 2015 mainline. It's been out 2015 mainline, 2016. 2017, it was in the Lamborghini series. And also 2017, there was a multi-pack exclusive of it. I think this was the first release of it in red. Again, headlights, Lamborghini logo. This one's got nothing on the side, but it does have a tampo on the rear, which is kind of cool. Again, this is a Lamborghini SUV. And if I could afford a Lamborghini, I would not be buying a Lamborghini SUV. I just don't know why they would try to get into that market. I don't know if they ever really made this either. This might have remained a concept car. It may not have. I don't know if they actually ended up. They might have ended up actually making it, but it's just not something I would buy. If I was going to buy an SUV, I don't know. It wouldn't be this. If I wanted some sport utility vehicle, it's not going to be a Lamborghini, you know, even if I had all the money in the world. So I'd buy a fast Lamborghini, not one of these, and then something else. Some company that was good at SUVs. If I wanted an SUV, I'd buy one of those. So probably a Land Rover, but whatever. Anyway, so here is this one. So that's it. That's going to be 10 cars. So 10 cars for 10 Car Tuesday, 10 Lamborghinis. And we got, in my opinion, the kind of lame ones here are the last three we showed. I love Countaches, but not tuned ones. I don't know, my favorite maybe. I do like the Veneno. I think the Veneno is a cool car. It's not the prettiest looking Lamborghini. It's really futuristic and angular and whatever, but it's wild looking, and that's how Lamborghinis probably should look. This is a nice clean one. I like that one. Not a huge fan of that one. I like this one too. And I like this one. I think so. These are my three that I probably really like. That's okay. And then this is, I don't know, whatever. I don't really like the look of that at all. All right, so that's it. So that's going to be it for this episode of 10 Car Tuesday. Thank you guys very much again for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe, all that great stuff. Let me know which one is your favorite of the group. And have yourself a great day.